同心的祷告，亲爱的天父爸爸，谢谢你让我们有个美好的一天。天父爸爸，求你给我的全家人有个健康的身体。谢谢你让我们有个美好的生活。谢谢你听我的祷告，奉主耶稣基督名求，阿们。
心事未曾看见，
小朋友，又过了一个星期，我们又见面啦。欢迎小朋友收看儿童教会的线上节目。相信小朋友都知道今天是父亲节，那祝线上的父亲父亲节快乐。小朋友，今天是如何和父亲度过的呢？有些孩子呢会自己动手弄个小卡片送给自己的爸爸，又或者弄一些好吃的小甜品和爸爸一起分享，或者送上一个爱的抱抱给爸爸。那无论你用什么方式来表达，这种都是对爸爸一种爱的表达。那么我们爱我们的爸爸也不只是今天哦，我们应该每一天每时每刻都来孝敬我们的爸爸还有妈妈，因为爸爸妈妈无时无刻都这么保护我们爱护我们。无论我们有时候惹他生气，或者是做错了一些事情，爸爸妈妈都一样的会原谅我们。圣经中耶稣讲到的时候有讲过一个比喻，就是父亲和儿子的比喻，让我们一起来看一看。
浪子的比喻，这是耶稣，他是上帝的儿子和救世主。当耶稣在世上的时候，他教导人上帝的爱，他医治了许多有病的人，又行了许多神迹，例如在水上面行走，甚至使死人复活。耶稣教导人上帝的爱，各样的人都来听耶稣讲道，包括收税的人，还有那些做坏事的坏人。这使到法利赛人和犹太领袖都很不高兴，他们认为耶稣不应该与这些人来往。因此耶稣给他们讲了这个故事。某人有两个儿子，有一天小儿子对父亲说，爸爸，我要你现在把我应得的产业分给我，在你去世之前。他父亲同意并把产业分给他。过几天，小儿子收拾他所有的，搬到远方去，在那里过放荡的生活。花光了所有的钱，一切用光之后，那地方发生了严重的饥荒，他开始挨饿了。他说服当地的农民雇佣他，那人叫他到田里去喂猪。这个年轻人饿得连看到喂猪的食物都想拿来充饥，却没有人给他任何食物吃。最后他对自己说，在我家里连工人都粮食充足有余，我反倒在这里饿死吗？我要回家跟父亲道歉，请他把我当工人用吧。于是他回家到父亲那里，当他回到离家还远的时候，他的父亲远远就望见了他，心里充满怜悯。原来他的父亲每天都在等他回来。父亲就赶紧地跑到儿子那里，儿子对他说，爸爸，我得罪了上帝，也得罪了你，我再也不配做你的儿子。可是父亲却吩咐仆人，赶快拿最好的袍子给他穿，也给他戴上戒指，穿上鞋子，把那只养得肥肥的小牛也牵来杀，我们要开个宴会庆祝一番。
小朋友，故事中的小儿子他要求父亲在去世之前就要分产业给他，其实这是对父亲的不尊敬。然而小儿子拿了钱之后就离家了，他离家后过着放荡的生活，把钱花光，也开始挨饿。这时候他才知道原来父亲还有家里是最好的，于是就打算回家向父亲认罪。父亲在他离家的那一刻就每天在家等着他回来，所以父亲一看到小儿子回来的时候，高兴地赶紧吩咐仆人把最好的上衣、戒指还有鞋子给小儿子穿上，还宰了一只肥牛来庆祝一番。所以小朋友，当我们做错事情的时候，只要我们真心地向父母认罪悔改，
父母也像天父一样的会原谅我们。让我们一起来祷告。
亲爱的主耶稣，今天是父亲节，求你施恩给我，帮助我孝敬爸爸，报答他的亲恩。感谢爸爸供应我的需求，尽力的养育我，教导我。主耶稣，你知道我爱爸爸，但我也知道你比我更爱他，所以今天我愿意借着祷告把他交托给你，求你看顾保守他，扶持他，愿他能够全心全意投靠你，一生都走在你的美好旨意当中。祷告乃是奉靠耶稣基督圣名祈求，阿门。
Good day to all of you. How have you been? Children, did you know that our lockdown has been extended for 2 more weeks? It means we have to stay home and not go anywhere for 2 more weeks. I'm sure you miss your friends, your teachers, and your church mates. Don't worry not, you can make a video call to your beloved friends and teachers. Now, here's a later question for you guys. Do you know what day it is? It's Father's Day. It is the day we honor our father and give thanks to them, like how we celebrated Mother's Day. Have you listened to a parable from the Bible called the Parable of the Lost Son? It is about a father and his 2 sons. His younger son asked for his part of inheritance and set off to distant country and spent his days away without working hard. So, as the famine came and his money all finished up, he found some work and it is to feed the pigs. It is by then he thought of his father, his family, his home, where he could live comfortably and protected from harm. He regretted his foolish action and set forth to head home. His father was delighted to see his son came back to where he should be. And this is where we all should be as well. We must remember not to stray away from our Heavenly Father too. How about our own fathers? Yes, we love them the same like how we love our Heavenly Father. Our fathers provide for us. Did you get to see your daddy went out for work every day? Maybe getting a little too busy to play with you? It is because he is working hard to earn money so that he may be able to provide everything you ever needed, a home. Our fathers are our mentors, teachers, coaches, spiritual leaders, and even playmates. And a father models the love of God to his children. This is why we should love our daddy, because they can show us how God loves us. And as how we love our God, we should love our daddy the same. Here's today's memory verse. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. This is in the book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 1. Let's read it again. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. That's all for today's short sharing from me. Now, here's a little homework for you guys. Let's make a happy Father's Day card for our beloved daddies to honor him and God as well.
亲爱的天父爸爸，我们要来赞美你，感谢神让我们在这个时间可以来敬拜赞美，聆听神的话语，感谢神每天的供应，赐我们健健康康的身体，爱我的爸爸妈妈和保守我们的心，是一天比一天更爱你，更亲近你的。我们如果不小心做了神不喜悦的事时，求天父爸爸原谅我。谢谢主聆听我的祷告，奉主耶稣的名求，阿们。